I used to think that we can do everything in 2 hours. In that 2 hour Zoom call with the breakout rooms and just the PowerPoint, everything that I do is going to be a learning cluster. It's the truth, you know, because it really helps with the learner. And that's what we want to see, changing the on-the-job behavior. I've been an educator since 1994. And so why should I continue doing that 2 hour thing that's really not working? You know, if it means for me to even take extra time, extra hour, extra research, extra study, extra interviews, whatever it takes to change the lives of those kids, that's what I'm committed to. And LCD was just a better way to help me to really do that work. She was like, Karen, I need you to read this book. And I was like, oh my God, I love it. And so that's how we became familiar with it. And then I had an operational manager and I let her read the book. I said, no, you got to read the book too, because we in this together. And so she read the book like in one day. She was like, I couldn't put it down. I couldn't put it down. It's so good. And so she was saying that, and I went on their website and they have a professional development that you could go to. I was like, oh, I'm going. And so that's how we came. So that you can actually put what you read in action. So you can actually engage on what you read, because the workshop is designed as a learning cluster. And you really get to experience what you read. And then it always also helps you to reflect on what you're actually doing and what you're actually getting ready to prepare and present. And so it helps you along the way to do some reflecting and some planning and some developing. So I think that's important, just to get to experience it. Now, it's a difference from reading something to really doing the work. I design and develop all of the professional learning activities for our directors. And I was getting bored. I was like, I'm so tired of doing these 2 hour sessions and just doing the same thing over and over. And I realized that I really wasn't changing on-the-job practice. And then when I read the book, and then I saw Kirkpatrick's rubric, I was like, we never get over a two. That's what I say. I say, I never get over a two. People may, because, you know, everybody come and they say, Karen, this was amazing. It was so good. That was so good. And I was like, okay, that's the one, right? Then they say, after they say it's so good, they say, oh, I really learned something today. But then that's it. I don't see you implementing it. I don't see you changing your on-the-job practice. And we can't even track the results. And so I was like, no, something has to change where they can really begin to really invest their learning into their job. We're doing a training on facilitation of equity. And so I said, let me do it on that so that it could be a head start and I could get feedback from not only the LCD people, but also the cohort members that was in the session with me. And they are so helpful. You know, it's like the thing that I like the most, because I like people to genuinely care about your work and what you are doing. And it's like, it's their passion. And it's like they know your work and like they know you from the beginning of time. It's not like you just met them 1 week ago, right? They make you feel important and they make you feel like your work is worth the time and effort to ensure that we're doing it right. And that's what I like about them. They make you feel like it's okay to make a mistake. You know, it's okay that it's not completely right. It's okay if you don't understand. That's why I'm here. And all of the support they offer, you can call me, you can email me, you can do that. And then trust me, if you email or whatever, you're going to get a message immediately. It's like so helpful. I just make you feel as though that you're special. I would recommend it to anyone who is in charge of leading the work around professional learning, even the chief executive officers, human resource managers, any manager, because they are in charge of actually training and developing. So I would say anyone who is in charge of ensuring that on-the-job performance, if you are going to evaluate and observe and provide feedback around someone's job performance, I think that it is your job to train them in a way that's going to allow them to change those behaviors, because you are ultimately accountable for their work. Everyone will be happy at their job. You will have high, you will have low turnover, high morale, people excited about learning because they feel like people generally care about me as an individual because they designed something for me so that I can be successful. So you're going to have people coming to work happy, people coming to work engaged, highly motivated, and people just wanting to do a great job because they feel that they are valued. I have some words for the people who created. Can we have a part two?